Hey, what's up everyone, and once again welcome back to Super Smash Bros. For Nintendo 3DS. Last time we took on All-Star Mode using Rob, and this time we are going to be using Ness over here. As for the palette swap, let's see, my personal favorite one I think is probably this one, which has this little gooey boy on it. I also like the kind of edgy looking one with the Mr. Satin shirt. You know what, we're going to go with that one, purely because it's got the purple hat and the dark shirt. He looks a little pop-punk, and you know what I don't get to do this year? Warped Tour, which is very pop-punk inspired, so, you know, that's my reasoning. That's my entire reasoning. Ness is me wanting to go to Warped Tour, but being unable to do so. So, yeah. Correction. I could go. However, if I did go, I would... There would be like a whole bunch of other consequences because work, and it would have to be unpaid time off I was taking, and etc. etc. It just wouldn't be a great idea for me to go at this point with my current work and financial situation. So, yes, I'm gonna miss out on the final Warped Tour, but I'll learn to deal with it. And I have friends who were going, so I'm gonna still get stickers from it and stuff like that. My friend Taylor is actually going, and I've already asked her, hey, can you get me a Warped Tour 2018 sticker? Because they usually give them out for free. Oh, I gotta have someone to get me the tank top. I just reminded myself. Okay, I'm gonna have to, I'll ask Taylor again. God damn it. Sorry, this is nothing to do with Smash Bros, but whatever. There we go, Ness kicks butt, so. Well, he kicks butt with, like, his back aerial and his back throw. And his forward smash. I'm gonna try, PK Thunder. I don't know how effective- not PK Thunder, PK Flash. That's the D-pad. I don't know how effective PK Flash is gonna be against, anyone in All-Star Mode, but let's see. Let us see. I also want to mention I slightly rearranged my desk last night. Wait, hold on. There was something I spoke about in yesterday's episode that after I recorded it, I was like, wait, I'm gonna have to, like, amend that, but I don't even remember what it was at this point, so. Oh well. Maybe I'll watch it over after this episode. I don't know! Anyway, I slightly rearranged my desk, I moved my mic so it's, like, attached to a different part of my desk, and it started creaking for some reason, which is just a little bit annoying, you know? It's a pain. Oh, I remembered the thing that I was gonna have to amend. I think it was a few episodes back. I was talking about doing overtime at work. And how originally I was doing 2 days this next week. And then I was going to be doing 1 day because they changed it. Well, guess what? It's back to 2 days again. It was a voluntary extra day, but I picked it up because, you know, money. Money's pretty good. So, yeah. But because of that, I ended up taking today off. That's why it says it's almost 4 p.m. On the bottom screen. Because the overtime gives you more money, so, you know, it's gonna kinda counterbalance, and I'll end up getting more anyway, but you know what? I needed the day. I'm working the day this video comes out, let's say that much. Alright, let's see. And now Minnie's howling. Can you hear her howling? This episode's off to a great start, hold on. Alright, update. Minnie's now in the room with me. She took a solid 5 minutes to figure out where she wanted to lay down. She was howling at nothing, of course, because she's a puppy. So, yeah, now you know if you hear loud howling or little oofs or barking in this episode going forward, it's because Minnie's in with me now. She was just kind of wandering around the house. She gets free reign of the house most of the time. But usually it ends with a howling at something out of the window that she really doesn't need to howl at, but we're trying to train her. If any of you guys have any puppy training tips, then please leave them in the comments, because Minnie's a handful. It's also been kind of a pain because it's only been myself and my sister for 2 weeks now, because my parents have been back in England. So, you know, we've been in charge of Minnie the whole time. And, well, she misses them. So she gets a little bit weird sometimes. But once they're back, we're gonna actually really kind of go hard with training, I think, because she kind of needs it, because she'll bark at people, like, even, like, if we let them into the house, so it's like it's obvious that they're okay and that we're fine with them being in the house. She will bark at them for hours on end. It's ridiculous. Even they'll give her treats, like we'll give them treats to give to her, and she'll still be like, she'll like shut up to eat the treat and then start barking again immediately. It's a little bit weird, but I mean, she's also still a baby. I've got to keep that in mind. She's like 8 months old. So, I can't expect her to be the smartest little puppo, but, you know, she's smart when it suits. She's smart when it suits her interests, I should say. Like, I went to reheat some of my pizza earlier, because I had Papa John's last night. And, well, actually, no, I should start the story last night. Hey, Ice Climbers, I ordered 2 Papa John's pizzas, and don't comment about the whole controversy going on with Papa John's, with the whole racist thing or whatever. I like the pizza, and that's why I ordered the pizza. I couldn't give a damn what's going on in corporate. So, you know, I just like the pizza. So I ordered that, and I went into my sister who had mini- Are you whining now? What are you doing? God damn it. What the hell was I saying? I went into my sister, we shared the pizza. Minnie really wanted some pizza, but she can't eat the pizza because she's a dog. So, we had both of the boxes on the bed sealed, and Minnie was like trying to find a way into the boxes. And I think she started to figure it out after seeing us open them a couple times, because she went to where the flap is that you like lift up, and she was trying to do it. I was like, see, when it comes to food, you're smart. But when it comes to, like, anything else, not too bright. Could you not do that? Could you stop? Could you let me hit you with my baseball bat? That would be great. There you go. And Wario, my friend, come here. No? I'm gonna try this holding A and B. Yeah, holding A and B to do a smash attack is very strange and only works some of the time. Oh, Minnie moved again. She was by the door whining and... Now she's rolling around on her back. Goddamn. Look, it's the Ice Climbers. I mean, I used to get really sad seeing that trophy, but I know they're coming back now, so I'm not as sad. What I am a little bit pissed off about is I should have taken 2% damage in that fight. I'm gonna take a heart container, because 99 is a scary damage to go in on. Especially to the Ganondorf and Cloud fight. It's not recommended. By me, anyway. I personally don't recommend it. Oh, and we got the Final Fantasy stage as well. What the hell is this place got? Midgar. That's the one. Right. Oh, there's a other nest. Come here. Yeah. Wait, I didn't try PK Flash yet, did I? Well, I'll wait until we get a few of these guys knocked out before I really try it. I should also be going for more upward aerials, because Ness has got a big old noggin that he hits with. Alright, I need to get that. Can I get that? Can I get that, please? Thank you. Update. Minnie is now by my feet. She's licking my leg. And it tickles. Oh, I actually managed to intercept Pikachu there. Not bad. Hit him a couple times and bye! Alright, Jiggly, how you doing? Well, they're dealing with the fire. Oh, never mind. Charizard doesn't give a damn. I guess that makes sense. Yeah! Alright, we hit Cloud. We did like 70 damage to him. It wasn't enough to kill though, and it's just awkward to hit with, so it's probably not gonna come in all too handy, honestly. Alright, you wasted his limit. Good. I feel like he didn't actually have to waste it right there. I feel like he could have recovered otherwise. Come here, Charizard. Nope, that's not what I meant to do. Come here, buddy. Back here! You got up to like over 200 just then. Alright, we actually might be fine. As long as we don't take too much more damage in this fight, I would feel comfortable going into the second to last one on that kind of damage, and then going into the very last one after having used another heart container. Right, can we not have to worry about this? Please? No, Sheik! I was kind of hoping that I could kill them before that happened, but nope. Now, what the heck does the water one do? I forget. Oh god. I don't remember what this does. Okay, it just makes water everywhere. Also, I guess you can't swim in Smash 4. Was that a thing that was removed from Brawl? I could have sworn that you could swim, but I made a comment about swimming in... I don't remember what stage it was, but it was a few episodes ago at this point. And in editing, I was like, wait a minute. Wait a goddamn minute. And then I checked, and I don't remember what it said, but I guess you can't swim in this game. Did they remove that? That seems really weird that they would do that, but... I mean, it explains why you just fall through the water in, on Tortimer Island. Ready? Minnie, what are you doing down there? She's like, buy my surge protector. I really don't want her to hit the button on the surge protector. Hold on, I gotta check. Minnie, what are you doing? Okay, she's moved. Good. Good. God damn it. You guys remember when I would record videos and they would go really smoothly? Because I don't. I don't. Anything post-late January 2018. It's like, eh, now there's a dog in the house. She's doing whatever the hell she wants, so... No, she doesn't care about the sign on your door that says recording. She's gonna scratch the door. Unless you let her in. So I now have to record, with my door slightly open. I used to have it fully closed and I have a sign on my door that says recording, so people know not to knock on the door and come in, etc. Minnie doesn't know that. Because of course she doesn't. So, I leave the door slightly ajar. I still have the sign up. It's just so Minnie can still get in, but people don't read the sign. People still come in. It's usually fine, though, because, like, the last time I actually got interrupted, it was during a... I want to say a Splat Today's episode? It was some weekly series. But, see, getting interrupted during those series is fine, because that's much more casual. And basically, Emily came into the room, and she's like, Minnie peed on me! So that was great. That was a fun time, and everybody heard it. So that was fantastic. Let's try another PK Flash. Boom! Oh. Get out of here, you ruined my PK Flash. Okay, come on. Yeah! Could we? Maybe. Okay, there goes Zero Suit. I need to get rid of my boy Toon Link over here. There he goes. Alright, I'm gonna be cheap. Lucario knows what I'm doing. Off you go, Lucas, and then I'm gonna get up because that rainwater's gonna push me and push me, and it's not gonna be a good time. Eh. Oh my god, I thought we just, like, killed him with a Pellet Posey for a second. Pellet Posey combo, let's go! That's how you do it. Pellet Posey. Was this stage ever legal in tournaments? I feel like probably not. I feel like this is the exact opposite of a legal stage. And there we go, just one fight remains. I appear to have misplaced my dog. She's now trying to get into the bathroom. I should probably just let her go out. I should probably open the door after this episode. That sounds like a good idea. But then if I do that, she'll also start howling at things. Don't eat the Lego. Minnie, don't eat that. I have my Lego Dimensions portal. No, she almost just pressed the power button on my Xbox 360. I have my Lego Dimensions portal close to the ground, like on a low shelf on my TV stand. And it's got the figures on it and she keeps wanting to eat them. Alright, there goes Luma. Bayo out? Bayo is indeed out. And Luma's out too, if that means anything. Oh, Minnie's now on the futon. She's exploring. She's been in this room many, many times for many, many hours. She's still exploring. That's for hitting me with a freaking soccer ball, my dude. Alright, I need to get rid of Luma again, ideally, because... Like, it doesn't count as a KO, but hey, it's Luma. Get rid of Luma, it's good. Get out of here. Get out of here. Okay. Did Shulk just backslash off the stage? I don't think I've ever seen a CPU do that before. But alright. Damn it, Rosalina. Why are you gonna be difficult? Wait, does that make them trip? Oh, Jesus. Alright. Duck pit, goodbye. Oh, not quite. I don't think I hit that with a sweet spot. Oh, almost got the dunk right there. I've never been all that good with... I'm decent at hitting, spikes or dunks or whatever the hell you want to call them with characters who have the moves that come out quickly. Except Mario. I mean, Mario's forward aerial is pretty easy to hit with, I feel. But characters like Ness, whose, down air takes a little while to come out, I usually miss with. Same with, is it Roy? No, I feel like Roy's is pretty instantaneous. I'm trying to think of anybody else who has a... But Rosalina's I find really awkward to connect with. Who else? I legitimately do not remember who else. Goodbye, Greninja! Oh, almost got that. I think we actually did get the spike right there. Goodbye! Well, wasn't that bad, Ness. Wasn't that bad at all. Let's see what our final time was. I feel like it's gonna be decently long. 10 minutes 50. And how fitting that we get dog ears. We got the right shirt though, so that's pretty cool. If that means anything at all, which it doesn't. Is that just a tiny villager face? What is happening? What on earth? That's kind of terrifying. What stage is that? I think I see Flying Man. Okay, so it's Magicant. Is this just like a low angle on the tree? Look at Tiny Ness and tiny villager faces. That was terrible English, but you know what? It's almost as if I'm not in England anymore, therefore! I have an excuse, question mark, maybe? I don't know. It's not even late in the day this time and I'm tired, what's going on? I swear, Mimi, you can't keep whining at me while I'm recording. I'll let you out of the room in a second. She's over by the door, she's like, come on, man. I gotta go out there. She doesn't have to go out there. She just wants to go out there. She's been out to pee not too long ago. Now she's scratching the door. Minnie! No! Gotta wait. I can't pause the credits. Well, I guess technically I can. Because I can do the... I could do the home menu. But no, we're not gonna do that. She can wait. She knows patience sometimes. Well, I mean, I guess not really. But yeah, that's exactly what this picture was. It's a low angle on that weird little tree, dude. And I guess villager and... No, villager's face looks really off. I don't know what it is about him, but just from that angle and it being that small... Yeah, he doesn't quite look like himself. But then again, neither does Ness. Ness is probably doing his... Okay. Taunt right there. Okay. No, the one that goes... Okay. That's the one. Wait a minute. Okay. Yeah.
Minnie, don't eat that.
You are impossible. Got comment question of the day. Not even a comment question, just a comment thing of the day. Go back and count how many times I said Minnie's name in this episode.
Okay.
So I think I've said this before. I have the World of Nintendo, like, 2.5-inch figures, or however small they are. I have them from Walmart. They come in this packaging where the figure is kind of out of the package, but it's still part of the package. And they're stuck on my walls on either side of my door, and they go all the way down to the ground. So a certain someone likes to nibble on the box of the one at the bottom, which is Toad, so... Anyways, rising PK Flash. A PK Flash that just keeps rising. Lower on power and sideways motion. We have PK Bonfire. Ba 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 ba. No. The lightning bolt doesn't travel as far, but the flame pillars stick around longer. We have lasting PK Thunder, which is a different color. Doesn't disappear when it hits an opponent, but deals less damage, so it's like Lucas's. And PSI Vacuum. Pulls opponents in and then deal damage at the end of the move. Does not pull projectiles in. So it completely defeats the point of the move. Cool. Alright, let's give this a shot. Rising PK Flash! Sure enough. It kept going. There's really no... In this area, there's no real way to show how high up that's going. Well, I guess... Kinda like that. Okay, PK Bonfire!
Yeah!
Alright. 36 out of that. Let's check the range. Oh, okay, looks a little strange. Oh, that's not that bad. Lasting PK Thunder! Yep, that's basically just Lucas's. Pretty much exactly Lucas's. Wait, can it still launch me? Okay, good. And PSI Vacuum. That's funky. It's not gonna work on this guy, but... Eh. 10 damage. Eh. 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 It's like he gets his own shine. Shine. Alright, not bad. That one's kind of neat. I like the pose he goes into as well. Stop that. I want to save. I would like to save. Okay. Oh god. Oh god, I was trying to disguise the yawn. Didn't work. Let's go find this, this young boy. Why am I scrolling? Wait, I need to get the alt trophies. That's why I'm scrolling so far. Ness, hello. Ness may have psychic powers, but that doesn't mean he shies away from getting physical. His side smash packs a real punch if you hit enemies with the end of his bat, and it can even deflect projectiles. His up and down smashes also have a lot of range. Ness can land his strikes with ease. His up and down smashes may have a lot of range, but they're not great. Those, you know, those freaking yo-yo attacks, I really don't find much use for them. Anyway, folks, that is going to go ahead and do it for this episode of Super Smash Bros. For Nintendo 3DS. Next time, we are going to be taking on All-Star Mode with Captain Falcon. I don't know why he's in his fabulous outfit. Captain Falcon may be on hard. I haven't decided. Probably not, though. Anyway, that's going to do it. So if you guys enjoyed, please make sure to leave a like and let me know what you thought of it in the comment section below. Stay tuned for the next one, and I'll see you guys then.